And welcome to another edition of A Shave and a Song, a show all about shaving with a straight razor while listening to some great music while we do it. Thanks for joining us today. Going to be shaving with my Dovo Bismarck 6/8. Going to be using some of my own shaving soap today. This is my own creation. It's called Tobacco Roads. It's got a nice tangy, tobacco-y kind of scent to it. I like it. Lathers up really nicely. Going to finish off. It pairs nicely with some fine Accoutrements American blend. And we'll be finishing off, as we always do, with a good old Clubman Pinaud. Well, we're going to do something a little different today while it's wet the face down and begin to lather. Actually, we got to lather and then wet the face down. Since it's getting close to Christmas, two and a half weeks or so away, you know that this time of the year always starts to bring out nostalgia. You know, we've already been listening to Christmas music since before Thanksgiving, but after Thanksgiving is really when the nostalgia starts to hit. See how quickly that lathers up? I did a good job on that one, if I may say so myself. And it smells really nice. So, in honor of the season, I thought I'd play a Christmas tune today, one that takes me back a little bit. This particular song was recommended by a viewer who also has some Christmas things available for you. I think we spoke about it last year. His name is Papa T, and he does some comics called Elfish. I'll see about putting a link to it in the description below. But he let me know about a Christmas piece that might fit into the format of the show. So I gave it a listen, and it does. Well, all music fits into the format of the show, really. But this one, especially at the time of the year, because like I said, it invokes some nostalgia. And this particular song takes me back to the first Christmas that my wife was at my family. It wasn't my wife back then, it was my girlfriend back then. And we weren't even engaged yet. So way back when, my family was always a singing family, except for my dad. My dad could sing, don't get me wrong. He could hold his own, but he didn't feel he was the greatest singer in the world and didn't really like to sing in public, and definitely was not a performer. That would be out of his comfort zone, but he would do anything for his family, and we used to sing in church as a family a lot, especially on Christmas Eve. We had kind of a program in church where people would read verses, and then other people would do special presentations, like, you know, singing or playing an instrument or something, you know how that, something like that. And my family would always sing. And so this particular Christmas, it was the first time that my then-girlfriend, later my wife, came to be with my family on Christmas. And as it just so happened, my wife, too, is a singer. We met in a select singing group in college. So she, naturally, was invited to sing along with the family. And the song we did that year was Little Drummer Boy. Now again, I'll mention that my dad is not a singer, at least not a performer, not somebody who feels comfortable singing in front of people, but since he's part of the family, he would get up and do it. But his role was to make the sound of the drum. You know, pum pum pum, rum pa pum pum. My dad was always kind of a funny guy too, and so he he would do the rum-pa-pum-pums, but he would kind of do it in his own little thing and kind of kid around with it. And when he got to the rum-pa-pum solo, just went nuts with it. Now everybody in church knew my dad, and knew our family, and it was perfectly okay. It was who we were. My wife, on the other hand, again, then my girlfriend, first Christmas with us, was not aware of this and was mortified at what my dad was doing to the song. But it was okay, because that's how he participated with his family, and others appreciated that. Battery low sign. Hopefully we've got enough to make it through. So this is from a 1990 album called Souvenirs from a band called White Heart, doing The Little Drummer Boy. And so as you hear it, it's a little different rendition of it. It's a good rendition. Hopefully it'll bring back some memories of Christmas for you as well. So here we are, Little Drummer Boy from White Heart.
Before the king, ba-rum-pum-pum, ba-rum-pum-pum, ba-rum-pum-pum.
There you go. From 1990, Whiteheart Souvenirs album. Little drummer boy. I almost started laughing during that because obviously when we did it in 86, I think. We didn't sound anything like that, nor had we heard anything like that at that point in time. Everything was all the traditional, but I can still imagine my dad just kind of rocking back and forth and kicking out in his cowboy boots singing pum bum bum pum 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 poly pum pum. Wasn't always in the beat that we were in. Oh, my wife did not think that was funny. There we go, we almost got through that. It's a little low for some reason now. Raise that up a bit. There we go. Then the battery ran out, so luckily it ran out after the song finished. So we can finish up the shave. Actually, just do this way. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope it brought back some fun memories of Christmas time for you. Kind of dedicating this one to my dad, who has been gone some 20 years now, but he was the first one that taught me how to shave, or had me shave with a straight razor, as I've mentioned in the past. I always enjoyed having fun with his family. And I guess my wife wasn't too upset about it, because she went ahead and a month later accepted my proposal and we were married. So there you go. That was Whiteheart and Little Drummer Boy taking you back a ways to the 1990s. And it's Christmas time. Hope you enjoyed it. Again, check out Papa T and his Elfish comics. It's great for Christmas. I'll put a link to it down below. Great Christmas gift. It's hilarious. He's got a couple of books out, and I always enjoy them too. So, and I'm getting nothing for this. I just he's the one who recommended the song for the day, and I read some of his stuff in the past, and it's good stuff. So check it out. And let's see. Oh, we're going to finish off with some fine accoutrements. American Blend. It's a good pairing to Tobacco Road today. That again, Tobacco Road is my own creation. Ah, I like this. I think I've gotten pretty good at making shaving soap. And I'm hoping that sometime after the first of the year, a local shop wants to start doing straight razor shaves, and they want me to come in and maybe show them a little bit how it's done. I don't know how to shave somebody else. I just know how to shave me, but they're also interested in some of my soaps. So who knows? Maybe I'll make a little bit of a dollar or some money on it and be able to pay for the hobby. All right, and finishing off with some Clubman Pinaud a little bit. Still got quite a little bit of that Tobacco Road. It really lathers up great, and it stays lathery. I like it. A little bit of plug for myself there. There you go, my friends. I hope you enjoyed today's show. Sorry about the little jump where the battery ran down, but we're back. As always, like the channel, subscribe, hit the little alarm bell so you know when we come up with a new show. We try to do it every week. And if you have any comments or suggestions, you want me to listen to an artist or something that might be a good fit for the show, leave that in the comment section as well. I'd love to hear from you. I'd love to hear new music. And as always, my friends, happy shaving and live life. I think I said that backward. Normally I said live life and happy shaving. There you go. Merry Christmas, everyone.